Hello folks and welcome back to another video. Today we're diving into 1Password, overviewing all of the information that you need to know about the business account. Now, as you can imagine, this video is sponsored by 1Password and there are 100,000 businesses using 1Password right now. I've been using 1Password for about 2 years after being nudged by my wife of a good password manager, surprisingly. And I've been using it for work and for managing my own personal passwords for quite a while now. It's definitely a time saver and a lifesaver when it comes to trying to remember and fully protect yourself against those sort of online threats. Now, out of those 100,000 businesses using 1Password, 25 of them are Fortune 100 companies, including the likes of Slack, IBM, Dropbox, and many, many more. Now, today I want to overview the 1Password business and give you a bit of an idea of what that includes, and then also some of the many elements of that experience. Now, to give you an overview for those who might not know about 1Password, it allows you to create and share unique and strong passwords. So as I said, for myself, I use it both for business and for family, and we do use it to, you know, save anything from, you know, Sainsbury's, groceries, and what password comes with that, all the way to team access as well, which is really beneficial because you can share it around your team members. Now, with 1Password, you can securely share everything for those who work with you and give employees access to logins, documents, credit cards, and much more using their secure platform. It has been available for quite a while on a range of devices, but you can get it on Mac, Windows, iOS, iPadOS, Android, Linux, and Chrome OS, as well as the likes of Safari, Chrome, Firefox, Brave, and Opera, and Microsoft Edge, which is really beneficial because that's probably most places where you're going to pop your password in. Now, in terms of creating a password, one of the features I particularly like is the password generator. And this allows you to create a new password. So before I actually go ahead and create a password, I'll test it through the system with the, you know, for example, the characters that are set by whatever site you're using, and then generate a password through 1Password to actually produce it, which is perfect. Now, you can also fill usernames, passwords, credit cards, numbers, and also addresses on websites and apps with a single click, which is super helpful. And there's a function called Watchtower, which basically gives you security overviews when your password has been compromised in a certain location. However, most of the time when using this, it pretty much covers that for you because, for example, if you're using one of the generated ones, you're less likely to then be compromised with your password. And I only typically get these when I've used a password in the past and I've saved it to 1Password and I've worked out, yeah, it's not as strong as it should be. And then I upgrade it in 1Password. So one of the things you can do is manage your vaults. And this is particularly useful for teams because you can manage your employee access with unlimited shared vaults and 13 vault permissions, which is perfect for sharing around your team. And you can even create custom groups to organize your team, manage the vaults they have access to, and grant them team level permissions as well. The ability, for example, to manage billing or even recover accounts. Recover accounts access for teams that can't sign into their account, which is really helpful to have. And you can also share vaults with people on a limited basis with 20 free guest accounts. So that's really helpful when you may have a freelancer working with you that you want to extend access to. I know this is something that I've done in the past. Now, talking about some of the more smart features, the integrations are a particularly impressive part for the business account. You do have 1Password integrated with Azure AD, Okta, OneLogin, and Slack, so you can provision employees using the systems that you already know and trust. And you can also import data into 1Password from the likes of Chrome, Dashlane, LastPass, SplashID, and RoboForm, which are other password management applications as well. So you can transfer over to this fairly easily. You can also configure the 1Password Slack app so you're automatically notified when anything needs your attention, and that basically pops up through Slack automatically, which is pretty helpful, especially if you're managing your IT department or HR and you want to be able to monitor how things are going with that. There's also an integration with Rippling, enabling you to have enterprise password management to secure HR, IT administration at scale. And you can integrate 1Password with all your websites, apps, and workflows using developer resources. Now, as you can imagine, the browser input is one of the best and most suitable ways to get started with it. But there are also a few features that are particularly helpful just to save you some moments and some stress as well. Like, for example, removing data from your clipboard. So, for example, you can set 1Password to remove the data from the clipboard after a specific amount of time. A feature that I didn't actually know about until producing this video, which is a really cool function, because then what you can do is just make sure that even if you have something copied that might be important, maybe even if it's not something that you'd expect, like it could be a pass, not just a password, but it could be, say, a passport number or something like that of an employee, where you can have that set up so that it just, you know, makes sure your clipboard's always routinely cleaned out. Now, it only works on verified browsers, so that you'll know that, for example, if you download a dodgy browser, it will identify the developer before you actually get started with it. And it protects against phishing as well. And so 1Password only fills credentials on sites where you've saved them as well. Now, you can protect your data from keyloggers. And so 1Password uses secure input fields to prevent other tools from knowing that you type in 1Password too. Now, when it comes to the pricing, there's a few options. However, the 1Password business pricing is $7.99 per person per month when paid annually. And you can try it out for free for 14 days with the link in the description. Now, as you can imagine, businesses that have additional compliance and administrative requirements can actually contact the team for sort of more advanced pricing and details like that. But there is a full sort of outline on the website with all that you need to know about the sort of details of this application. Everything from what the encryption, the audit logs, the SOC2 compliant elements of it. But as you can imagine, they can probably answer your questions in much more detail. Now, I've been really impressed by 1Password, and you know, it's impressive that I've been using it for only a little bit of time, despite actually needing it for a much longer period of time. So shout out to my wife for actually mentioning that to me. She's been a long time user, and so she'll probably be happy with me actually doing this, and I'll probably end up having to buy her something just to say an appreciation. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed this overview of 1Password Business. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll include the links in the description below. Thank you very much to 1Password for sponsoring today's video, and hopefully this overview gave all the information that you need to know. Thanks, folks, and cheerio.